What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? We are in Search and Destroy, and today we're using an M8, but for a reason here. All right, a reason. The reason is a Search and Destroy swarm. I decided I'd do a little how-to video. Even though the game's been out for a while, a lot of people struggle in Call of Duty, not just in Search and Destroy, but in Respawn as well. And I wanted to make a how to get a swarm video in Search and Destroy specifically. But, you know, it's similar in Respawn, the what you're going to do. Some of the things will cross over, and we'll go into that. So, as I stated, we're starting with an M8A1. It's one of the best rifles in the game for Respawn and for Search and Destroy. Both, it works very well in. It's very strong, especially if you have great accuracy with it. If you don't practice, okay, you can practice. You don't have to use it, but it does help to use good weapons. So, MSMC for an SMG, M8A1, AN94. Some people like the SCAR in Respawn. I understand that as well. It's very strong. So weapons like that, that can, you know, you can get a lot of kills with pretty easily. You could do a, you know, a challenge swarm, we'll call it, and like, I want to get a swarm with an executioner. Okay, you can go for that. Your chances are lower. Let's just put it that way. So, first you see me using the M8. Second, you see me, I'm sound whoring that guy, for example. I'm using dead silence and awareness in search. It's very easy to sound whore people with those two perks, and I should say have a headset, you know. So it helps me out when I'm playing solo, and I can sound whore it, which will keep me from dying a few times that I might die to otherwise. Very beneficial for me. Thirdly, all right, now this is very important. Use everything you can to get points. As you saw right here, I hear this shock charge over here, and I run over and I shoot it for plus 50, and I double back because I want to like throw off my position where they don't know where I'm at. But I do that a few times during the game. I shoot a few shock charges, and that's to get, you know, 100, extra 100 or 100 to 50, 200 points. Which might not seem like a lot at first. You're like, it's only 2 points, Marksman. That's 2 kills. All right, 200 points is 2 kills. It's very beneficial. All right. In search, though, there is a little glitch. Keep this in mind, that when you kill the last player here, it's actually worth 150, but only 100 of the points go toward your score streak. So you see plus 150, but only 100 go toward it. So you don't get 150 points, really. It's 100. Keep that in mind. Sometimes people are like, I had to figure this out. It took me a long time to figure out and add up. So, just remember that, okay? Remember that. Another point to keep in mind is that the objective does help you. Capturing hills or, you know, arming the bomb, disarming the bomb, especially if you're able to finesse your way into getting bomb explosions for plus 300, that is an enormous benefit to get a swarm. 300 points is amazing, plus the 100 you got for arming it. So, doing that alone is 400 points. Now, to tell you this, I'm using Hardline, so it is a little bit easier to get swarms, about 1570 instead of 1900 for points. 1570 points for a swarm instead of 1900. It's a bit easier. That's 3 less kills, basically, but it's also much easier if you get a bomb explosion, since you really need to average about 400 points around if you want to get the swarm, which is essentially 4 kills, or, you know, a few kills and an equipment kill, or a bomb arm, or an explosion. Just keep that in mind, okay? It is helpful to remember how many points you need to average per round to understand, okay, well, if I did bad this first round or second round, whatever, I need to step my game up the third round. And stepping your game up might mean, you know, playing more aggressive. So just remember that. Now, another thing I think you should do if you have a goal to get a swarm, or, you know, high streaks in general, Hardline is a huge benefiting. I like to benefish things. I just catch a lot of fish as well, I benefish. It's a big benefiting factor, all right? Hardline is very beneficial if you are going to go for swarms or dogs or VTOLs, whatever. Even VSATs, really, it's very, very easy because it's only like 900 points or 800 points for a VSAT or 1,000 instead of 1,200, right? Something like that. Anyway, it's very helpful, all right? And I suggest you use it with Flak Jacket. I try to do that as often as I can. But my M8 class uses attachments. There we go. Accessories. That's what I get for not thinking. So I use Reflex, FMJ, and Stock. So it's kind of difficult to fit in Flak Jacket and Hardline with Toughness and Dead Silence Awareness, you know? And I think Dead Silence and Awareness is kind of needed in Search, but it might not be needed in Respawn, so you might be able to get away with using Flak Jacket Hardline instead. So, next, you want to go to your score streaks. I think that those are important. I'm running UAV VSAT Swarm because those will help me get points with my guns, which are plus 100 per kills instead of getting plus 25 or plus 50. So it's a little easier. At the same time, if you're playing Respawn, you have people that can spawn back in to get a kill again. That might be more beneficial if you use, let's say, a VTOL or something. You can get more points because you can get a lot of kills really quickly. Well, in search, you can't really do that. It limits you. So I would say that using stuff to either get assist points or to get kills, like the UAV gives helps get you kills, the VSAT helps get you kills, that is going to be a better idea and more helpful because you'll get plus 100 for kills instead of plus 25 or plus 50. Again, my opinion. Right here, you see me camping in the back. This was a campy bitch move. Because my teammates took the bomb and ran up, so I decided I wasn't going to help them. I was going to sit back here. I was hoping they actually died, and then I could clutch the round out with the VSAT. Yeah, selfish, I understand, but sometimes you have to play that way when you're going for a swarm. We were up 3-0. We weren't in any danger of losing. The bomb was down, so I had an opportunity to grab the bomb and arm it for plus 100, get the explosion for plus 300. I shoot the shock charge there for 50, and I have 200 points per kills for kills left in the game. So there's a lot of ways you have to add this up, and it's helpful if you remember how many points you're at within the game to kind of factor it in. And you have to remember the points you actually have. Remember, plus 50 for the last kill doesn't count. So you have to remember how many points you actually have to know how far you are from the swarm. And right now, I have to play really campy because I wanted to defend the bomb. I wanted to get plus 150 for the bomb kill because you actually do get plus 150 for those. If someone's disarming the bomb and you kill them, you get a bomb defense plus 50 points. So that does count toward your streaks. Also, I figured I could get a bomb explosion if I played it right, and that would get me to the swarm as well. Unfortunately, I don't get to call it in, but I do get the little clutch right here when this guy jumps up. I double it up and pick off the guy at B and the guy jumping through the window. Swarm awaiting orders. Nice to hear that. But I hope you guys enjoyed the video. This helps you at all to be awesome. If it doesn't, I'm sorry. Looking forward to doing some big streaks in Search and Destroy and Advanced Warfare, and I'll see you guys then. Have a good day.